Welcome to this quick video tutorial on SGD's Go Term Finder. Have you ever wanted to analyze sets of genes to discover which functions, biological processes, or cellular locations are overrepresented or enriched in your gene set? Well, the Go Term Finder tool uses Gene Ontology or Go annotations to do just that. You can find the Go Term Finder by using the purple toolbar that runs across the top of most SGD web pages. Just mouse over the Analyze button, scroll down, and click on Go Term Finder. The Go Term Finder searches for significant shared Go terms or parents of Go terms used to describe your set of genes. This information can help you understand which functions, processes, or cellular locations are most relevant to the genes in your list. We say these Go terms are overrepresented or enriched within the set of all annotations for that set of genes as compared to all annotations for all genes in the genome, or whichever background set of genes you choose. The Go Term Finder interface allows you to select the ontology that you want to analyze, choose between the default background set or your own defined background set of genes, and allows you to select the p-value cutoff for reporting these results. Step 1. Enter your gene names. To get started using the Go Term Finder, enter your gene names of interest in Step 1, separated by a return or a space. Or if you have your genes already saved in a text file, you can just upload that file instead. Note that it needs to be in a .txt or .tab format. Step 2. Choosing your ontology. Are you interested in biological processes, molecular function, or cellular component? Here in Step 2, choose function to investigate elemental activities, like catalysts or binding, that describe the actions of gene products at a molecular level. Choose process for terms that describe multi-step events, things like signaling, transcription, cell division, things like that. Or choose component to study cellular locations and complexes. If you want to use default settings, just click search. If you want to customize, you can choose different options in step 3, 4, and 5. Optional step 3, customize your background genes. The default background set is all genes in the genome that have Go annotations. If instead you'd like to limit this set to only a portion of available genes, enter those gene names, separated by a return or a space. Or if you have your background genes already saved in a text file, just upload the file instead. Remember that it needs to be in a .txt or .tab format. You can also choose the types of genes that are included in the background set using these checkboxes. Optional step 4, refine your background annotations. Here we can choose whether or not to exclude high throughput annotations. You can also select different annotation sources or evidence codes. Optional step 5, choose your p-value. The default p-value is less than 0.01, but 0.05 and 0.1 are also available. Here you can choose whether to calculate false discovery rate, or FDR, with your results. When you have finished making your selections, just click search. The results are shown in both graphic and tabular form. Colors in the graphic indicate levels of significance based on p-value and relationships between the different terms that are shown. The table lists matching term names, the number of genes in the query list that map to each term, the number of genes in the background that map to each matching term, p-value, false discovery rates, and expected false positives, as well as genes in your original query list that mapped each term. If you'd like to take your results with you, click download to generate a spreadsheet containing the information shown on the page. If you have any further questions or suggestions, please contact us at sgd-helpdesk@list.stanford.edu.